How's it going, Arky Squad? I hope you guys are doing well. Welcome to Fast Fact Fridays, a video format where I give you guys facts about architecture as fast as possible. So for today's video, we are going to talk about scale model materials, or more specifically, what boards should you buy for your scale model, in which I am going to discuss the prices, quality, and ease of use of each of the boards on our list. Because you know guys, I was once a student too, with little budget and even smaller knowledge based on what to purchase. So yeah, that's why I wanted to share my knowledge with you, my dudes. Anyways, let's start with the first material, the chipboard. So the chipboard is the cheapest board on this list, hence its name. It comes in at about $1.20 for a 26 by 19 inch board, which comes in roughly about 34 centavos per square foot. In terms of aesthetics, it has this gray recycled board look to it. That's really why it is called chipboard, is because it's made up of recycled chips and papers. It comes in at a variety of thicknesses ranging from 0.6 millimeters to 2.4 millimeters. In terms of cutability, this is one of the more difficult materials to cut, requiring multiple passes for a clean cut. It is also prone to delamination, where the layers of the board come apart rather easily. I would typically use this board for preliminary block models where you are going for earthy muted tones, or you could just stick some stickers on it and use it for final presentation models. The second board on our list is called a corrugated plastic board. This comes in at about $1.70 for a 16 by 24 inch board, or around 64 cents per square foot. So this board looks like a corrugated box, but made out of plastic. It comes in at a variety of colors, but most commonly come in blue, red, yellow, green, white, and black. The most common thickness for this board is at around 3 millimeters. In terms of cutability, this is one of the easiest to cut board on our list, often only requiring two passes to achieve a clean cut. The only problem with this board is that the edges of the board have very little surface area, making gluing 90 degree wall connections quite tricky. So this board is best used for models that require a linear texture, like container houses or structures with board sidings. Our third material is the foam board, or some call it foam core board. This board will set you back $2 for a 16 by 20 inch board, or roughly 90 centavos per square foot. As its name suggests, this board is made up of a foam center sandwich in between two thin layers of paper, and it comes in at a thickness of 3 millimeters, 5 millimeters, and 13 millimeters. It also comes in two colors, white and black, which is kinda racist. Why are the Asians not represented in this color spectrum? Jokes aside, this is one of the easiest to cut boards, only requiring one stroke from your blade. Unfortunately, it is also a very fragile material. It is prone to indentation when you apply too much pressure on it, like when you squeeze it with your nails. But aside from that, this is the easiest material on our list to work with due to its ease of cutting. That is why it is often used for quick study models or block models. The fourth material on our list is the sintra board, which comes in at around $3.40 for a 15 by 20 inch board, which is about $1.63 per square foot. So of all the materials on our list, this is my favorite because it is made up of a high quality PVC, meaning it is waterproof and very durable. It comes in at multiple colors, but can most commonly be found in white variation. Again, racist. Anyways, it comes in many thicknesses ranging from 1 millimeter all the way to 19 millimeters. When it comes to cutability, this is the hardest board to clean cut in my opinion, often requiring more than 5 passes to cut. So if your model has curvy lines in it, this isn't the material for you. You're better off going with a foam core board for that easy sliceability. Fortunately, the sintra board is made up of a score and snap material, meaning that you could just score the surface of where you want to cut the board and then just apply pressure to the opposite side, and bingo bango bongo, your sintra board is cut. Anyways, let's move on to our fifth and final material, the mat board. Now, this board is probably the most expensive out of all the boards out there, which comes in at the same price as the sintra board, around $1.63 per square foot. And I don't know why it is so expensive. It's just basically like a high-end illustration board. It is made up of multiple layers of cardboard laminated together. So yeah, it should be a lot cheaper than the sintra board. Usually, this board comes in at a off-white or cream color, but it also has a ton of other colors for you guys to choose from. It just depends on where you're buying it. In terms of cutability, it is just a little bit easier to cut, compared to the chipboard. So mainly people use this for picture frames. You know that border around your graduation picture? That's made from a matte board material. So aside from using it for picture frames, architects often use this because of the way it looks. And also it is one of the easiest materials to glue together because of what this material is made of. And with that, I guess that is the end of our list and the end of our Fast Fact Fridays. So if you guys liked this video and found it somewhat informative and you've learned something, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe down below for more architecturally related videos from me, your boy Leon. I will see you guys on my next video. Flying peace!